Alright guys, welcome to another episode of season 2 of this Motorsport Manager season. Well, some of you may wonder why this episode starts with a photograph. Well, that's because I forgot to record round 3 of this GP3 season basically. And basically we've done fantastically in that race. We achieved a first and third finish, which is undoubtedly one of the best in the series. But basically it's a very boring race in Monza in Italy, of course Milan Grand Prix, but basically we were in third and fifth, and then that leading team of Zampelli Engineering, I believe it is. Well, they just have reliability issues and have to pit two more times, which means Pernet just gets first place. Yeah, it's a fantastic result, and I get the team principal award for the first time ever in this whole series. And how good is that? Just fantastic. Anyway, as you may enjoy this just drive from Alistair Griffin, or Alistair Griffin, we will move on to the new episode in a very short time. And here it is. It's time for more Motorsport Manager action. And away we go here for round 4 of the European Racing Series. So, heading to the midway point of the season, we are heading to Portugal for the Tondela Grand Prix. It's a very, I don't know, twisting and turning track, it looks like. There are two main straights, but they don't look particularly long, which means that the aero setup should be a little bit more towards a high downforce, and the gear ratio should be a bit towards acceleration as well, as I will just check one more time to ensure that I'm recording this time. And yes, I am. So it's sunny weather here in practice, and I will do the practice right now. So downforce, oh, that's very high, and he actually wants understeer, which is very interesting. He actually wants understeer instead of oversteer. Okay, I'll give them the super soft tire. This downforce is going to be very interesting. 17.5 and 27.5. Excuse me. Let's see if this is going to work. But yeah, he's got too much oversteer, which means this suspension has to be a lot harder. And we'll move this towards acceleration just a little bit. Okay, confirm. Let's see what Porter wants. Also very high downforce, but he wants high oversteer. Look, the speed balance is kind of mystery, but it's a little bit towards acceleration. So 17, so I will give him a little bit more aggressive one, 18 and 28, actually 17.5 and 27.5. Yeah, just don't risk too much. He actually wants more oversteer, so we'll give him a softer suspension, and I would like to go to, let's keep it into 50%. Let's just don't move it, basically. And let's take the practice as usual. Six lap stint, soft tire. Six lap stint, super soft, beg your pardon. Let's go. The right aero setup, so 50% for Porter seems to be working, which is very interesting. The handling according to Pernod is fantastic, so he indeed wants a little bit more understeer. And he is only 9 tenths of the pace of Marcellella, is Pernod. Okay, so Porter is happy with the oversteer setup as well. Okay, that's very interesting. The aero feels fantastic, your high downforce setup. So both of them think the setup is pretty decent. Let's see if they can get the setup knowledge a little bit higher. The tires are so hot. That is a, well, an interesting thing to watch. Or, I mean, to be watched in the race, because I don't want their tires to degrade too fast. Gearing seems just right, okay. Really happy with the gear ratio. You know what? I will bring both of them in at the end of this lap. And then just tweak the setup just the slightest. Just a little bit. And the set of super soft. I don't think they need that many super soft anymore. So, okay, downforce is great. Handling is good. I will give him just a little bit more downforce. And a little bit more understeer. There you go. He is good, good, good. Alright, more downforce. More understeer. Let's see, more acceleration. Is that gonna work? More understeer. Let's actually give him more oversteer and more acceleration and see how this is gonna affect him. Just a little bit more. Three laps of fuel. Go. Away goes Paul, Pernet, not Pornet. And away goes Porter. Both of them are driving again. A new set of super soft tire. I will push for the engine, and yeah, the tires are really hot. They're really, really hot. It's actually a purple sector one. Wow. And a purple sector two. I don't think these guys, yeah, they are not using the super soft tire. That's why we set up purple lap time with Pernat. 118.6, that's 3 tenths faster than Marcellella. That is unbelievably quick. That is unbelievably quick. Wow. One more lap for Pernat. Proto's not gonna get one. Oh, he is going one more lap. I don't think these are gonna go to level 3, but it's already fantastic that they can go to level 2. But the tires are super hot. That's a thing to keep an eye on. They didn't give any feedback though on this new setup. I don't know if that means good or not, but practice makes perfect. That's a new achievement unlocked. Okay. Interesting practice. That's the first time we've gone up to first position in the practice. So the race is gonna be sunny all the time because it looks like it's like in the desert. I don't know if this part of the world in Portugal is actually very hot, but it looks like that way. Okay, so the handling actually degrades okay. So he wants more oversteer. There you go. I'll give him 63%. I'll drag it back. I'll make a gamble, but why shouldn't I? Super soft is only gonna go 9 to 11 laps, though. You know what? We will start on mediums. No, we will start on softs. Go 13 lap of fuel. We'll go soft, super soft, and super soft. Or actually, soft, super soft. It's got the performance increase, but not the durability. But the soft isn't gonna go that long, though. Yeah, but the soft is decent in speed as well. Medium, it just got schweiz speed. Okay. Let's confirm that. Yeah, so apparently the downforce and speed bands are great. Just a little bit more understeer. Let's just give it to the middle, basically. He is starting 12, so he's gonna start on. He's not that good in the durability. Look, he can only go 8 to 10 laps on the super soft, while Pernet can go 9 to 11 laps. Tire up a fuel, soft tire. He's probably gonna do a soft. I don't know. Let's just give them neutral and high. Let's see how they go. Let's start the race in Portugal, round 4 of this GP3 season. So these two quick guys, or this quick. Good actually, Batista starting nice. Yeah, Marcelo starts. Oh, he actually starts on mediums. That's a very interesting strategy. Either way, it is lights out. Not yet. It is now lights out in a way when Porter gets an appalling start. He gets a really poor start. Gonna put push on both of you. Don't attack just yet. Porter is dropped down to 15th now. Okay. So it's a traffic jam. Actually, attack. You've got enough fuel. He's down to 16th. Are you kidding me? Come on, make the overtake. Go past El Sadat. Now come on, don't get squeezed down, mate. Porter, you gotta do better. You gotta do better, mate. Porter, yes. Come on, round the outside. Round the outside. No. Okay, Pernat actually went around the outside of Mello. Porter is diving down the inside and up into 15th. Okay, that's a fantastic move. Now, push and high. You're up to a temperature, neutral and high, okay? Okay, that's a fantastic move on Batista. Oh my goodness me, Porter is up to 12th. I think someone has crashed. Not Vanaden, it's Jafas. It's only Jafas. And Batista? Yeah, Jafas and Batista have crashed. That's a fantastic news for us because Batista is one of the quicker cars in the field. Okay, we can go back to neutral. The tires are really getting hot and they're degrading very fast around this track. Pernet is up to 15th, battling with Alcedas side by side. Porter just passed Chu up into 11th, just about. Pernet is in a four-way battle with Sa and Mello. Alcedas has been absolutely, oh my goodness me, Chu. You are a dickhead. You are a dickhead, true. So again, Porter crashed out around the first three laps. That happened yet again. I can't believe that. Pernell is up into 13th position, as he is now right behind Vanana. He dives down the inside but is unable to make the move, and Sai actually passed him. Okay, and here comes Alcedas. Pernat, don't hurt your car. Okay, this is not looking good, but that's a good move. And another good move. Vanaden got squeezed out by Saar, and Pernet now up into 13th. So it's Marchetta in the lead with Diaz and Santana. These three guys are not that quick, to be perfectly honest. Okay, Porter is still in the pits. Pernet is trying to attack Vanaden round. Sorry, it's Antonov around the outside, and he makes that move stick just about around the corner down the inside of Evans. Now around the outside of the final corner, it's not gonna work, and Antonov has shot up the inside. Pernet went back up the inside of Evans, but he got squeezed in by Evans. Pernet went round the outside of Evans now, and that is a beautiful move. So Pernet is now 20 seconds behind Marchetta, as Porter comes out in 20th position, as you would have expected. He's 8 seconds behind Chu, who's actually chosen to go onto the medium tire. I'll leave Porter again because he's just got no luck at all. Look at these tires, it just doesn't make any sense. Why are they so hot? Just why are they so hot? Give me a reason, mate. Pernet is now trying to overtake Rogers. He's just done that. Rogers tried to dive him back the side by side. And Pernet takes 10th position. Porter sets the fastest lap of the race. Interesting. So a lot of drivers who start on the super soft tires were pitting at the end of this lap, so we need to see the gap to Maslala, which is 5 seconds, 5.5 seconds. So Pernet should be in fourth position. Actually, no, only Santana went into the pit. So Marchetta, Savara, and all these guys are going to go around one more lap, and so is Valdish. And Porter, sorry, not Porter, Pernet has to try to overtake Valdish as soon as possible because he's just down at 130, while Pernet's down at 125. He's gonna dive him somewhere or went around the outside. That's a fantastic move. That's what conserve your tires, mate. You've done a fantastic job pulling that. It's looking good. Porter is up to 19th because Evans pitted and he's currently behind him. I will conserve just a little bit. Okay. Pernet is now up into 7th behind Cavalcanti and Saar, and he's actually caught up to Marcelera. The gap between him and Marcelera is now 3.7 seconds. So this track or this setup, whatever it is working for us, and Marcelera just got absolutely squeezed out. I don't know what the deal is, but it looks like Marcelera isn't going too fast as well. And Pernet is coming into the battle right now. He's down the inside of Marcelera as he takes 6th position. Oh my goodness, that's very dangerous. He nearly gets taken out by Cavalcanti as Marcelera dives back down the inside of Pernet down or into turn 1 rather. So Pernet is now up into 4th because more people have pitted for medium tires. Porter is still stuck behind Chu though. Pernet went round the outside of Marcelera and up into 3rd. That's a fantastic move. It's Marcelera. Marcelera is on medium. He's on neutral and medium. Pernet is only pushing the fuel. He's trying to conserve his tires. He's trying to go as long as possible. 44% though. Okay, 43% back to neutral. 3 laps to go for Pernet. So the soft tires will go 12 laps. So 12, 12, 8, I think will be Pernet's strategy, provided that there's no crash or anything like that. He's caught up to Cavalcanti very fast, as Porter is now up into 16th. Excuse me. Okay, Pernet down the inside. No, don't make contact. That's a great move by Pernet. That's a fantastic move. Oh, Cavalcanti trying to dive back down the inside. That won't work, mate. That will not work. So Pernet trying to go 2 more laps on these, well, almost dead tires as Porter passed Valdes for 15th. Porter is making progress. He's trying to go back into this race. Problem is though, Pernet and Porter will both go 2 more laps. But they won't double stack because they're very far apart from each other. Oh, I mean they are 30 seconds away from each other. Marchetta on the fresh super soft tires is absolutely flying and he's caught up to Pernet. So Pernet will not defend from Marchetta because they're not on the same strategy or anything like that. So Pernet is going to pit at the end of this lap. Another set of soft tire. I've put him 12 laps of fuel only. Parts are looking good. Fast pit stop. Porter. Yeah, he will go soft and super soft as well. 12 laps of fuel. Fast pit stop. Porter is now down his LJ fast and he makes another move stick. As Pernet is actually still in first position. Very interesting. Porter is now trying to attack Santana. He's absolutely on the charge. He could go back to something like 10th or 9th. As Pernet pits with Marcelera. The refueling is good. Tires is good. 12.5 second pit stop. That's a fantastic pit stop, I have to say. Okay, Pernod coming out of pits just behind or just ahead of Antonov. So he's technically in third place behind Sabato and Sarkis. Marchetta is on a different strategy essentially. Okay, so just conserve your tires, both of you, Porter and Pernet. Pernet is 3 seconds behind Saar. You don't need to push that gap too quickly. You can just, lay back, I would say. Conserve a little bit. Don't push too hard, because this track is going to kill your tires if you're not careful. Porter's got 13 laps of fuel somehow. That's very interesting. So he can push his fuel a little bit more. Yeah, he only needs to go 11 more laps basically. But what if we let him get to the window of one more lap possibly? It could be possible, you know? It could be possible, really. Let's see. I'll make Porter go one more lap, then Pernat. Think Porter is trying to go medium very soon, but at least I is catching him in a rate, what are you even talking about? Okay, Porter is gonna go medium all the way to the end. I think, yeah, but at least I is definitely pushing like hell. I'll let him through if he actually wants to go. Okay, that's a fastest lap. Wow. Yeah, Porter is not gonna defend from Bautista. If you wanna go through, you can just go through. It's fine, mate. You've gotta let something go before grabbing the big stuff, as Pernet is now only 2 seconds behind Saar, who is 6 seconds behind Sabato in turn, and Marchetta is about to pit by the look of things. There's a slow car, I think it's a left car there of Evans, and he really needs to get out of the way. He held up Pernet just a little bit, only cost him 1/10 or 2/10 rather. Not too bad. But he actually didn't get a chance of passing Porter, which was also fantastic. And Porter is now into 14th because Rogers pit. Okay, that's the reason. So this seems to be a very settled down race now, because there's no battle currently. Everyone is going just fine, just minding their own business. Porter is gonna challenge Mello. Pernet is now 4 seconds behind Saar. Some didn't really turn it up, he's neutral and medium. But the tire temperature is really an issue here. And oh my goodness me, the grip's gonna get higher, which means the temperature is gonna stay. And we can't really push the tires basically. Nobody is actually pushing apart from Marcellella, who's now only 2 seconds behind Pernat. And some of them are pushing, but not like what we saw before, as Sabato takes the lead. That's because Marchetta pits. Makes a lot of sense. So Pernet is now back up to third. I'm wondering that Marchetta could go to the end. Porter actually finally got passed by Bautista. What a surprise. Alright, if Marchetta actually want to challenge Pernet, just like what I did to Bautista for Porter, Marchetta can just go through. But his car is not dropping off into pieces this time. Noise barista, so they must have improved their reliability. Which is not a good thing for us, really. Pernod can just push a little bit, he can go 6 more laps, and Porter can also push a little bit of fuel, both of you. Pernod is still around 8 seconds off the lead, 8.1 that is. Okay. Let's see this out. So 5 more laps after this one for Pernod, which means he's gonna go to the end of lap 24. That's an 8 lap stint on the Super Soft. For Porter, it's gonna be a 7 lap stint on the Super Soft tire. So Porter has about half a lap of extra fuel, or less than half a lap actually. Pernod has a lot of, not a lot of, but also like 0.3 lap of extra fuel. And Porter actually repassed Bautista. That is a shock for me. But it means he's making progress, which is a good thing, I guess. Diaz and Valdez, they're double stacking. Why? Why would you double stack your drivers? It's unnecessary, man. It's not like the necessary situation where you have to double stack. It's not a necessary situation there. Oh my goodness, Marcella has a pace dropping. And that's exactly what you want to see now. That's exactly what you want to see. Actually, Porter, no. He's been punted off, but no damage on the pod, actually. Slight damage on the front wing there. Okay, just don't push too hard, okay? Sabato actually made his final pit stop for... No, he's gonna do one more pit stop. You see, he's on super softs. And Diaz on this brand new set of mediums is pushing like hell. So Mallow is also, oh, he's attack on tire. He's attacking. Okay. Overtake on fuel. I think Pernod's got an extra fuel or two. Go back to conserve. Porter really has to back up. Back up Hannah and high. Because I don't think his tires are going to go 4 more laps. It's 44% wear. But we'll try. Actually, Pernod's done a better tire wear than Porter. He's got Saar right in front of him. Wow, okay. And Saar actually pits, so Pernod is going to inherit the first place, but he's low on fuel. Just a little bit low. 1.9, that's fine, though. That's absolutely fine. This has been also a very boring and also a very weird race, just like the last one in Italy. Our cars seem to have improved quite a lot. And the fastest team, Marcella and Bautista, they just can't sort out their reliability issue. I don't understand why. Maybe they've got a shite mechanic or engineer or anything like that. Porter's repassed Diaz for 11th, he was passed by Diaz. And Pernod is going to cross the line with 1.01 lap of fuel remaining. And he's got Bautista coming out on brand new Supersoft, who's going to be quicker than him, but he's a lapped car. And how is this going to work? He's going to pass Pernod. And then he's going to be shown, he's going to be okay, he's faster than Pernod, so he can just get away. Okay, that actually works fine. Because I don't want to get Pernod held up. And Sabato actually has closed down on him. And what the hell are you doing? Bautista, you dickhead. You're a dickhead. Uh-oh, I forgot to let him pit. No. I bottled it. I forgot to pit him. I forgot to pit him. What a joke. I bottled it. I'm not gonna go to Porter. I have bottled it. Put it out of the field. He's retired. Wow. I have absolutely bottled it. I don't believe it. So they're gonna double stack now. I don't believe this. I can't believe it. Okay. Why is this thing son of a... Okay, stop. Stop. I can't believe it. Marcella has retired. Got a technical issue. They were pitted. Pronouncing 11th. Okay. I've actually bought it. I still can't believe that. Marcel has to come out again. I think that's him, yeah. So we're gonna still hit the objective of the sponsor. Because we're gonna finish in 9th position. Porter has actually been lapped, so he's got a lot of laps to do, has he? They're all gonna be lapped very soon. Pernet is 70 seconds behind Saar. What a joke. What a joke of a race. I'm sorry, but I really have no intention to continue this race anymore. Let's just fast forward it. I don't even mind. I can't believe it. That's so stupid. That's such a stupid mistake. Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my god. I've just thrown away a podium, a possible win even. Pernas has a fast lap. Okay, that's 2 more points. Or 1 more point. Or I don't know how many points he's gonna get for that, but yeah, kind of a good news, I guess. kind of good news. He's even gone faster, 119.2 is per net. Sabato went on to win past Stein in the last few laps. Really should be third at least. But things do happen. Yeah, things do happen. Okay. All right. Don't check cars. There's no risk of rule break. Got two more points, bonus points for fastest lap. I let him go for it. And he deserved the third place. He deserved 20 points actually. Because with his past lap as well. But instead, Sainz gonna be 1 point ahead of us, ahead of Pernet, at least. And Porter drops down to 10th. If we finish third, we'll be 1 point behind Eastwood Motorsport. Instead, we're still 5 points behind them. And they should be saying that we rock, not Eastwood Motorsport. Okay, that dude is pretty decent, that fan, Juma Katafuchi. Either way, this is a really frustrating race. It's not like that I have no chance of winning or going to the podium at all. It just isn't good. Paulus' morality dropped. As a mechanic, both of them dropped a lot. Well, they double stack, which shouldn't really happen, but it does happen. And in Formula One, Sebastian Vettel wins, Kimi Raikkonen second, and Fernando Alonso in third. He's actually finished one lap behind. Wow. That's the Formula One, basically. The difference is so big. And we finished 7th and 15th in this race. Absolutely disappointing. But Pernet is still in 2nd. It's only round 4. We've got 6 races to go. We've still got a big shout for the championship. Interview. We're testing weekend for Pernet. Yeah, I'll take the blame. It is my problem. Porter struggled. I'm sure he will bounce back soon, of course. Does that improve anything? The chairman is still very happy. Marketability is up to 51%. I can't see the morale here, yeah. I can't see the morale here. Either way, the car repair is going to be finished. There's an issue. Of engine cooling system. But I really can't fix it. Can we continue with Can we continue just without doing anything? Otherwise, it's gonna be minus 50 reliability. We can't continue. We're gonna take the minus 50 reliability. And we're gonna improve that part. The engine is 31%. Jesus Christ. I will leave that on. But, yeah, 10 days before race. Okay, just go. I don't have $500,000. That's how poor I am. That's how poor our team are. Okay, sponsors. 13, so above 90 and then 20 per race. That's 5, that's 50 more for 3 more races only. So definitely I'll take this one. Why didn't come before that dilemma? I still can't pay 500,000 because we'll be below 5 million. I'm really out of money. Yeah, I'm really out of money. Oh, sorry for that. So next race is in Belgium. It's basically Spa. I hope I don't battle it at least. I don't care if a car is going to be good enough. There's a scouting report for VL, not good enough. Exclusive. Sabato's future is in doubt. So he's gonna leave MRT. Yeah, this report is just nothing more. Let's just continue. Okay, there's a something. Okay, the reliability walk is finished. The marked ability went minus 15. Caught embezzling. Huh? What does that mean? I didn't even know what that word means. Embezzling. What the hell is that? He's got. Oh my goodness me, he's stolen money, jeez, okay. So the car is improved, now the reliability is improved up to 80%, okay, fantastic. We will continue to improve the reliability of the engine, not the engine, the brakes. Let's see what is important. Next race, the front wing and the engine, okay. Then very easy. But so yeah, the parts are looking decent, but we don't have money to build new parts, which is gonna be a problem. All right, it's a political vote on 28th of June. Rear wing can be developed. It's not going to benefit us. It will not benefit Eastwood Motorsport, so I'm voting for 4. Yes. Great. The rear wing can be developed next season, I believe that means. It's Alexia's birthday. Don't be too much money. Okay. Okay, 10. That's fantastic. I can have that money. Yes. It's a pony, it's actually a woman. I kept saying he, but it's actually a she. So the Formula One went to, where is that? And Sebastian Vettel picks up another wing and Kimi Raikkonen scored no points. So Vettel has got 15 points in two rounds and is now first position. Wow, it's a Ferrari one too as well with that weird, let's just, no, this is not Christian Eriksen's, Marcus Eriksen's, but I don't know who this Swedish is, but yeah, I'm going to travel to Jalen's, Ardennes, whatever it is today. 87, so let's put these on, just let them go basically. Okay, actually, yeah, I didn't improve front wing, but it's too late, so never mind. Let's just go with 10-10, some mail. We didn't really get these kind of race interviews, race previews anymore, like telling me how many laps there is. Maybe it's because this is season 2, so it doesn't matter anymore, but yeah. Yeah, this is basically episode 3 of this Motorsport Manager season, and yeah, it's been an up and down episode. We've got a first and third last race, which I unfortunately didn't record. And this is, we've got a chance of third and maybe 10th if he didn't get double stacked. But in the end, we only finished in 7th and 15th. So it's been a nightmare, but hope you have enjoyed it. If you have, leave a like and subscribe. And I will see you next time. Goodbye.